See, what I did right there, I just paid to win. I just literally threw my wallet at the game and I just swiped and I made like a billion silver and I could spend more because I still have leftover pearls. Hey, my name is David and welcome back to another video. As the title states, I'm going to be talking about pay to win and how this really shouldn't be a thing in the game. I just want to put a disclaimer out there and say that if you are spending money on this game like I just did, but multiple times over, then that's fine. That's you, that's your money, you've worked for it or whatever. Even if you didn't work for it, it's your money. You can do what you want with it. That's fine. But what I don't understand is how Black Desert claims to be a pay for convenience game and nearly the entire player base also. And I mean, I can't disagree with you. There's a lot of stuff in this game that is like pay for convenience, namely a value pack. That's probably the most pay for convenience thing. There's artisan memories. I guess those are also pay for convenience, quote unquote. Anyways, what I'm trying to get at is that I shouldn't have been able to just throw my credit card at the game and just make a billion silver. I've calculated it out, and it seems that you can make probably around 10 billion silver on costumes alone per week, which is absolutely insane. I mean, you look at that, and then you can take a look at somebody's gear, and they could say they were 100% legitimate with their gear, they fully enhanced it or bought it with themselves, but they can also leave out the part that they threw their credit card at the game and spent $10,000. I feel like if you play this game relatively enough, you will make progression in this game with decent RNG. You will be able to get gear, and I don't think you'll have any issue eventually, maybe after a year and a half, to be able to compete with the end game players. I mean, not the top end game players, but the average end game player. And I was watching a stream yesterday, and there was the GM of Camel, and I think he spent a little over $500 that stream. I quit after a while because his enhancing was a little bit of monkey style ape. I was thinking to myself how someone that doesn't actually play the game have 715 gear score. You guessed it. I'm assuming he probably paid a lot of money or threw a lot of money at the game to be able to get where he is, because he stated multiple times over that he does not have time to play the game. To be 715 gear score and not play the game is a feat in itself that if it was done legitimately, that would be absolutely insane. You must be a god, and you must be playing like 16 hours a day with some pinoys on the side. But you know, that's besides the point here. If you do the simple math and you could take an average guesstimate, an account like that, you're probably looking at $75,000. Now, for the average player, that's a lot of money. I bet that a lot of us are sitting at home, we're either working or we're in school. We don't have $75,000 just throw at the game. A lot of us have student debts, a lot of us are paying bills, a lot of us are living on our own. And I just can't wrap my head around the fact that you can go out of your way to progress as much as you want in this game, do it fully legit, 100%, no pearls involved unless you're spending for artisan memes or using it on a value pack so that you get a little bit more money off the marketplace, but not doing what I just did at the beginning of the video, and then finally reaching a point where you feel strong, like let's say 560 gear score and being proud of it, and then somebody can come along and just say, yeah, you know what, I'm gonna swipe my card and I'm going to be able to get 600 gear score, screw your 570 gear score or 560 gear score, whatever, I don't care, because I have full pay to win gear, I'm full pen, and I don't even need to be good to just face roll you on wizard or witch or whatever class, something stupid like guardian. That's an entire video for another time. It just feels like invalidates all your progression. It just feels like at the end of the day, why even bother? Because no matter how much you try to get ahead of everybody else, there's always going to be somebody that is a oil prince that can just throw their card at the game. Now, I'm not saying that I haven't done that. I've bought a few costumes, and I wouldn't say I spend extravagantly on this game, but I have done my guilty share of spending 20, 30 bucks on an outfit here and there to be able to get some Cronstones. Now, there's a difference between buying costumes for Cronstones for your own attempts and then buying costumes to be able to sell to the market just to make silver. There is an argument to be made that, you know, people that are whales, they keep the game free. Technically, the game's not free, but there is always that thing where you can't really expect to pay a one-time fee and then have everything accessible to you. It does make sense that whales are needed, because in every single game, whales allow a game that is free-to-play, which BDO is not, but let's say it was, to stay free-to-play. Do I agree with that method? Sort of, kind of. But I don't think they should have an advantage that greatly dwarfs everybody else that does not swipe. Essentially, if you look at it, in this game, BDO is really gear dependent. You may disagree with me and say that, oh, you know, skill sort of overtakes gear, but at the end of the day, gear is everything in this game. In the early stages of this game, gear score is okay. Somebody can be like 20, 30 gear score above you, and you can still relatively kill them easily if you know how to play your class. Now, the further on you get into the game, though, with the higher gear score requirements, the more predominant that gear score difference actually matters. Well, let's say I'm at 550 gear score and I'm fighting somebody that's 600 gear score. That 600 gear score player, unless I play perfectly, is normally going to win 8 out of 10 times, 100%. And that's just because 50 gear score is a lot at late game. I think that advantage is a little scummy, because in a game that proclaims themselves to shy away from the pay to win model, that don't like the pay to win scene in general, it's a blatant slap to the face that pay to win is just hidden behind a curtain that a lot of players don't really tend to see. I'm not directly buying gear, so technically it's not pay to win. I'm just indirectly funding myself with money to be able to buy the gear, is the argument I've heard a lot. And the entire issue that whales fund the game is, it doesn't really apply to BDO, because BDO is not a free-to-play game in the first place. If it was, I can maybe accept that fact more, but because it's not, and I still pay to be able to play the game, not a monthly subscription, that I understand, it's still buy to play with pay to win conveniences inside the game. I would actually rather have a system where I pay monthly and I still get all the benefits of everybody else and just completely remove the pay to win, because I think all gear in this game should be obtained legitimately, and I think that all gear should be something that players look forward to. It's not like at the end of the day you enhance something and it feels good to tap that enhance. Does it feel good to be able to just throw your credit card at the game and say, heck yeah, I got pen? No, of course not. Even in the worst possible scenario where you constantly fail pen over and over and over again, and it's not even a sense of gratitude when you get it, it's not like, fuck yeah, I finally got this piece. It's like, no, it's like, fucking finally. Even at that point, it's still joyful to be able to get that pen, no matter how long it took, no matter how many billions I spent into it. But for me to just go ahead and go into the pearl shop and click away and buy pearl outfits and list it, that's not fun. It's literally just me hitting a couple buttons and getting billions. In no way did that bring me satisfaction, I can guarantee you that. I think at the end of the day, paying to win takes away from the immersion of the game. You may have a different opinion, and like I said at the beginning of the video, if you pay to win, then that's fine, that's cool, but don't flex on me and don't tell me that you have all this gear and at the end of the day I find out that you paid to win that gear, because then you just look stupid, because you didn't really earn that gear is you just bought it with real money. You essentially skipped everything, and that's, to me, is a casual gamer. You're not even a real gamer at that point. I wouldn't even label you as a gamer, because at least a gamer would put in the effort. If you're honestly looking for a way to pay to win, and no, if you're thinking that I'm jealous of people that I guess have more money than me, that's not really the case. I guess you can assume that because I sound a little salty in this video, but no, I'm kind of going more on a rant, because Pearl Abyss clearly does not stand behind what they say. YouTube makes me quite a bit of money, I'm not gonna deny that, and I have a very solid trust fund that I can dip in whenever I need to. I'm financially independent. That's something that I'm gonna put out on the table, and yes, if I wanted to, I could throw $50,000 at the game. I've done it for Vindictus, I can do it for BDO, but it's not something I wanna do, because as I've mentioned earlier, I wanna be able to earn my gear, I wanna be able to feel like I did something, not just hitting a couple buttons and then bam, easy pen. Which, you know, at the end of the day, if I had no time to play this game, maybe I would do that. Maybe. There's a slight, small chance. Honestly, if I didn't have time to play this game, I wouldn't even bother. Because if I didn't have the time to enjoy the game, why am I going to spend money on that game, right? Anyways, I'm going to be wrapping up the video here. I don't want to keep going on this tangent. But what I want you to take away from this video is that pay-to-winners are casual gamers. And two, Pearl Abyss does not stand behind what they proclaim. And three, in my opinion, I think satisfaction comes from playing the game and enjoying the game, not just by using a piece of plastic. Then again, if you're one of those people that does get happiness from money, then like I said, by all means, go ahead and keep swiping. If you enjoyed the video, leave a like, subscribe to the channel, join the notification gang, and let me know in the comment section down below if you agree with the pay to win scenario or you disagree with it. Check out my Twitch, linked in the description down below, along with the Discord, and I'll see you in the next one. Stop this gravity.